I would like now to invite our distinguished speakers to take garlanding ceremony, please.
Reached that the outcomes of this 3 days event will be conveyed to.
Thank you. What a wonderful tradition, I believe. It's a great form, and I shall be your master of ceremony this morning.
Mr. Vino Asano, the Assistant Secretary General of the ACP Sustainable and Economic Development and Trade Department. Excellency Sujiro Sims, the European Union representative to Pacific Island countries. Members of the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Bulam Nakatiwa. I join my earlier colleagues to welcome you all to Fiji and to this meeting and discussion forum here. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to commend the African and Caribbean and Pacific Secretariat for launching this series of regional meetings with the aim, with the main purpose of bolstering information, development, knowledge sharing and networking. I wish to also commend the thought put into the joint ACP-EU private sector development framework and the events being organized with technical support from Business ACP, which is ACP's private sector development platform in close cooperation with the European Union, European Commission. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is only fitting that we have come together here in Nadi to remind ourselves of the crucial role that private sector plays in economic growth in today's times. The private sector is the engine of economic growth and job creation. We, the government, provides the public infrastructure. We provide an enabling environment. But at the end of the day, it's the private sector which must lead growth and development for the growth and development to be sustainable. However, sustainable and inclusive private sector-led growth does not happen on its own accord. To make it happen, the private sector needs to be encouraged, supported, and welcomed. While the main objective of this event is to target ACP stakeholders, intermediary organizations, other beneficiaries, we must first and foremost focus on the micro and small and medium enterprises. A focus on giving our MSMEs the necessary tools and business enabling platform to build capacities that might help them to gainfully participate in meaningful economic activities. I'm encouraged by the agenda of this three-day event and the crucial role that it will set for private-public partnership, an opportunity for a much more pronounced role the ACP and the European Union might play in our region. I do hope that it will open up opportunities for questions to be answered by the members of the private sector whom, at the end of the day, this workshop is meant for. Ladies and gentlemen, in setting our goals to this end, we need to look at the dynamics our region and the vulnerabilities of our countries that our countries are subjected to. We as small Pacific small island development states are already acutely aware of the inherent vulnerabilities that has long defined our development pathways and projections. Mindful of these vulnerabilities, can we then beg the question, how do we keep up with the pace of an ever-changing global environment and business context against a backdrop of shocks caused mostly by large economies, our trading partners, and even natural disasters? And how do we build resilience, our ability to bounce back from the shocks? The answer to sustainable, fair, and green business practice is both awareness and appreciation of the impacts of our business decision and practices placed to our environment, our economies, and our people. It is therefore useful and timely that this meeting is taking place when several new intra-ICP projects and substantial private sector financing facilities are being launched and expanded to help seek out these answers under the 11th European Development Fund, the European External Investment Plan. If you have heard closely the address by Mr. Sujiro Sims, you would have noted the pockets of funding available, and one may ponder whether we can really access this. There are two aspects of these funds. One is the ability to access, fulfilling all the requirements. And the second is the governance framework post accessing those funding. No one in the region denies that there must be a proper governance framework for utilization of the funds. Accountability and transparency is paramount. No one denies that we must get the maximum out of the resources that is being provided by the European Union. But the issue is not that is being often raised by members of the private sector. The question that often raised by the members of the private sector is that, how do we access these funds? How do we meet the requirements? There are often, many times, a lot of pockets of money, but the requirements, accessibility, is designed in a manner as if you basically want to block people to have access these funds. So I do hope that this 3-day meeting workshop will be able to deal with those to make the accessibility part very much easier without compromising on the second aspect of governance framework. Ladies and gentlemen, there is an urgent need to strengthen and transform the ACP group and the Secretariat as the global context has radically changed since the first Lome Convention. So the discourse should also look at what are these changes that are required, keeping in mind the earlier issue that I raised. I'm happy to see that this is already underway. ACP is positioning itself to be a major global player in sustainable development of the ACP member countries. I hope that we can use this time to strengthen opportunities for regional partnership, and I hope that regional countries will share the issues and raise these issues in a common voice to be effective. Through this platform, comprehensive information on relevant intra-ACP programs and the various European Union programs and facilities targeting the ACP regions should be conveyed, and criteria for assessing eligibility are really threshed out. It is also important to have a high degree of interaction among ACP private sector participants, and I do hope that those who are not here today are also given opportunity to participate and access these ones. Let us commit, therefore, to make available the right and smart financially inclusive solutions to really achieve the intended target and the intention of this this project that European Union is and wanting to get to the Pacific and the ACP member countries. We need to review our current conditions, create an economic environment that meets the goals and targets of each of our national development plans, and have these aligned with the global development plans, such as the Agenda 2030. Let us seize the unique opportunity this workshop affords us. Ladies and gentlemen, with these words, I wish you well in your 3-day workshop, and I look forward to receiving the results of your successful deliberations, and I look forward to seeing the stats on the pickup rate, the number of players in the private sector. I see some players here with the deal with agriculture. At times they come to us, and I always say, tell them that, you know, we don't bankroll investors. We are here to provide an enabling environment, the legislative framework, and we do invest in public infrastructure. But these are the opportunities, and of course the financial sector is there, and I do hope to see this place actively getting into accessing these funds and leveraging us from the commodity framework to product framework, value adding, so that we do a lot of work downstream here, and the maximum benefit is derived by our people, and we gain in the country. Thank you. Naka.